हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, माई सेल्फ गणेश बियागलावे, वर्किंग एज एन असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ मैकेनिकल इंजीनियरिंग, वालचंद इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी, सोलापुर. इन दिस सेशन ऑफ कंडक्शन वी विल सी द डेरिवेशन ऑफ रेट ऑफ हीट ट्रांसफर थ्रू द वॉल. लर्निंग आउटकम: एट द एंड ऑफ द सेशन स्टूडेंट्स विल बी एबल टू डिराइव वन डायमेंशनल हीट कंडक्शन इक्वेशन थ्रू प्लेन वॉल. Now, in last session we have seen general heat conduction equation through Cartesian coordinate system. Now, for plane wall, we'll try to derive the heat conduction equation. Suppose this is the wall, plane wall. Its left surface has temperature T1, right surface has temperature T2. These are the surface temperatures. The thickness of the wall is L and the conductive heat transfer is Q. As we know the generalized heat conduction equation, that is dou square T by dou x square plus dou square T by dou y square plus dou square T by dou z square plus q g by k is equal to 1 by alpha dou T by dou t. Here I can write for one dimension d square T by dx square plus q g by k is equal to 1 by alpha dt by dt. Now, as the internal heat generation is absent, that is the assumption, so it will become 0, and under steady state condition the temperature can't change. So what I can do now, I can write d square t by dx square is equal to 0. If I take 2 times integration, then I will be getting the equation T is equal to C1x plus C2. This is the equation number 1. Now, to find out the constants C1 and C2, we required to apply the boundary conditions. We will be using the boundary conditions. So, what are the boundary conditions? First boundary condition: at x is equal to 0, this is the x and this is the x-axis, x is equal to 0 and x is equal to L. At x is equal to 0, the temperature, surface temperature, is T1. T is equal to T1. And second boundary condition: at x is equal to L, T is equal to T2. So applying first boundary condition and substituting in equation 1, I can write, instead of T, it will be T1, which is equal to C1 into 0 plus C2. So the constant C2 will have the value T1. Then similarly, using second boundary condition, the equation 1 will become T2 is equal to C1 L plus, what is C2? C2 is T1. So I can write this as T2 minus T1 is equal to C1 L. So C1 will become equal to T2 minus T1 by L. So here we got two constants C1 and C2. Now substituting constant C1 and constant C2 in equation 1, we can have the equation 1 as T is equal to T2 minus T1 by L into X plus T1. Now this can be further written as, I can take T1 in the left hand side, so t minus t1 will be equal to t2 minus t1 bracket complete l into x. Now I can take t2 minus t1 on the denominator side, so the equation will be t minus t1 by t2 minus t1 is equal to x by l, and this equation is known as temperature distribution equation. This is known as temperature distribution equation. Means what? By using thermocouples, we can measure the temperature T1 and T2. So, T1, T2 temperatures can be measured, length can be measured at any x distance. Okay, you can substitute here the x value, you will be getting the T, unknown temperature. And the temperature distribution, if you start finding at 1 mm, 2 mm, etc., etc., the temperature distribution slope will be like this one, linear slope will be there. So this was the first part. Now in the second part, we will find the rate of heat conduction. By using the Fourier's law, I can write Q is equal to minus Ka dT by dx. So as we know the temperature T, okay, I will write temperature T equation as T2 minus T1 by L into X plus T1. So differentiating it with respect to X, I can write dT by dx is equal to T2 minus T1 by L plus 0. So in the equation 2, I can substitute this one. So Q will be equal to minus Ka T2 minus T1 by L. Okay. Now the area here, K is the thermal conductivity. K is the thermal conductivity of this material. A is the area normal to heat flow. A is the area normal to heat flow. So this is the area, this much area. If I will try to draw the isometric sketch, then the area will be L in here I will be using letter B and C. So here A will be equal to B into C. So remember, you should select the area normal to the heat flow. Okay, so further I can substitute now, or I can simplify it. Q is equal to, now can I remove the minus sign? Think over it. Yes. So this can be written as Ka T1 minus T2 divided by L. This can further be written as, written as Q is equal to T1 minus T2 divided by L by Ka. As you know the electrical analogy, can you tell me the thermal resistance present over here in the equation number 3, which is the thermal resistance? Yes, you are correct. So thermal resistance will be equal to L by Ka. More and more thermal conductivity, lower will be the thermal resistance. Lower will be the thermal conductivity, that is the insulating materials. Higher will be the thermal resistance. Okay. Now, here the area you have to keep it as a constant. Thickness you have to keep it as a constant. You have to compare two different materials. Now, So in this video we have studied the temperature distribution equation. We will summarize, that is T minus T1 divided by T2 minus T1 is equal to X by L. This is the equation A, the temperature distribution equation. And second equation, that is Q is equal to T1 minus T2 divided by L by KA. This is the equation number B. So today in this session we have derived these two temperature distribution equation and rate of heat conduction through the plane wall. Further, for further study you can refer Fundamentals of Heat and Mass Transfer by Incorpora David. Thank you.